أعماله وأعماله وكذا ويأتي إلى المسجد، والشيء الوحيد الذي يسمعه في الصلاة هو الصريخ. فأقول لك طب أنا رايح دماغي وعربيتي والبنزين وأصلي في البيت أحسن، تمام؟ فنساعد على يعني على هذا الأمر من باب وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان. فمن كان معه أطفال صغار لا يميزون، تمام، ولا يعقلون، فمن الأفضل إن هم يصلوا في الخلف، يعني في علامة وضعناها على الباب، لأن المسجد عند الرجال وعند السيدات مقسوم إلى قسمين، فما في مانع للإخوة اللي معه أطفال صغار يبكون إن يصلوا في الخلف، حتى إذا الأطفال بكوا لا يؤثروا على بقية الناس في المسجد. وكذلك الأمر عند السيدات في الأعلى، عندهم المسجد مقسوم قسمين، فالأخت إذا كان معها أطفال وصلت في الخلف، فإذا حتى الطفل صرخ صوته لا يؤثر على بقية المسجد، وهذا من باب يعني مساعدة الناس على الخير. So before we start, inshallah, there are two sections in the men's area and two sections in the ladies' area. It is better if you have kids who keep crying in salah, it is better to pray in the area in the back. So if the kids cry, nobody will hear them in the rest of the masjid, and also they will not affect the khushu' of other people. Because technically, some people drive long distances, they leave their work, they leave their families, they drive their cars, they pay for gas, and they come here, and all they hear is screaming in the salah. So they don't get any khushu' in the salah. So please, we need to help one another to gain khushu' in the salah. Jazakallahu khair. الأمر اللي نتعلمه اليوم من صحابة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه رضوان الله عليهم مسألتين، يعني في الدقائق المتبقية. الأمر الأول هو مسألة المودة والرحمة في العلاقة بين الزوج وزوجته، ونضرب أمثلة من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن أصحابه، وإن كان في متسع من الوقت نتكلم عن مسألة العدل بين الأولاد. إنه أنا لاحظت يعني في الشهور اللي جلستها هنا في المسجد إنه يومياً ما في يوم يمر إلا ويتصل اثنين ثلاثة خمسة تزوجين بدهم يتطلقوا، ونقول يا أهل الخير إيه سبب الطلاق؟ يعني تجد أسباب تافهة يعني لا تؤدي إلى الطلاق. كلهم يعني هل هو هذا هو السبب اللي أدى إلى الطلاق أن توصلوا إلى هذه المرحلة المزرية؟ يعني ما في أسباب لهذه المشاكل. السبب الرئيسي هو عدم وجود المودة والرحمة بين الطرفين. So today, inshallah, we'll talk about mawadda and rahma, kindness and mercy and understanding in the relationship between a husband and wife. And we'll give a couple of examples from the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum. It breaks my heart, literally, every day, to hear people calling me every time I open my email. Okay, I want a divorce. Okay, fax machine, I want a divorce. People sending telegrams, people sending letters in bottles, and they throw them in oceans. In every possible way, people are calling, coming in person, okay, I want a divorce. Yesterday, someone was coming to know, he wanted to know about Islam, and I gave him the full time because the brother was interested in Islam, and all of a sudden, I got a knock on my door, the brother and sister from one country in Africa. And she said, my husband, she was in tears, and she said, my husband wants to divorce me because I'm black. Okay? And both of them, you know, are black. The country where they live, they are black, okay? So I said, first of all, you have to take an appointment before you come because this is a big issue. Number, I have someone and I have an appointment. And number two, did he know that you were black before he got married? Or something happened, or you lost your color? What happened? And she said, he's not happy with my color and anything. I said, first of all, he is black, you are black, your kids are black, so what's going on? She said, I don't know. So I spoke to him, he said, I don't know. I said, you guys, you don't know, how can I know? Go home and come back 2 years, inshallah, after 2 years, take an appointment. What's going on? People are going nuts. They want to divorce for no reason. They just make up excuses to come for divorce. Again, there is no mawadda and rahma. والله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم قال إن يعني أسس الزواج الناجح هو المودة والرحمة، ومن آياته أن خلق لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran that one of the signs, one of the miracles of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is that He created for us spouses, husbands and wives, so that we can live with them in mawadda and rahma. And this translates to love, mercy, understanding, harmony, respect, إلى آخره. Indeed, in this are signs for people who reflect. ولكن سبحان الله ما تعرف if because of financial problems, because of psychological problems that people have, they want to divorce. It's like people are going crazy. I don't know what's going on. And I thought maybe when I give a series of khutbas a few months ago, I gave 3 khutbas about divorce, hoping that it will diffuse the situation, nobody will come for divorce. But now, alhamdulillah, more and more people are coming for divorce. I wish I never gave the khutbas. I wish I never gave those khutbas. ما في مودة وما في رحمة. كان في نحكي لكم نقطة عشان I'll just say a joke, man. I'm not worried. A brother and sister, they are married, they hate each other. They have kids. And their families, they don't like each other. No mawadda, no rahma. So, the son went to his mom and said, Mom, what is the origin of man? Where did we come from? She said, Alhamdulillah, we're from Adam, we're humans and everything. Okay, so he went to his dad and said, Dad, I asked my mom about the origin of man, and she said, you know, we're from Adam, alayhi salam. He said, no, don't listen to your mom. We are monkeys, okay? Man is from monkeys, okay? The theory of evolution, Darwin, and all that stuff. So the son ran to his mom and said, you were teaching me wrong. You said we are from Adam, but my dad told me that we are from monkeys. She said, my son, there is no contradiction here. When I said we are from humans, I was talking about my family. When he said, we are a few monkeys, he was talking about his family. So there's no conflict here. لو نظرت إلى حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مسألة المودة والرحمة يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في فترة من الفترات في أخريات حياته كان متزوج بأكثر من واحدة وكان يعني عنده هموم تبليغ الدعوة والدفاع عن المدينة والعمل الصلحي مع فلان وإرسال الوفود واستقبال الوفود وكل هذا ومع ذلك كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عنده وقت كما ورد في صحيح مسلم ومسند الإمام أحمد وغيره كان يحلب شاته ويخصف نعله ويحيك ثوبه وينظف بيته كان في مهنة أهله كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يخدم أهل بيته طب ما كان عنده يعني مشاغل وكذا بحيث أنه متزوج وعنده ناس في البيت يقول لفلانة أنت تغسلي الأطباق وأنت كنوسي وأنت تعملي وأنت تطبخي وكذا وهو يقعد باشا صح ما يعملش حاجة ولكن كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يخدم بنفسه المشكلة مع بعض الإخوة المتزوجين اليوم بيظن أنه لما يروح البيت رايح فندق يفرق بره طول اليوم ويعمل اللي بده إياه وبعد كده يروح فندق في نيويورك وهيلاقي واحدة تأكله ويشربه ويظبطوا له السرير بتاعه وياخد مزاجه وبعد كده يمشي فندق ومراته بتبص له من ناحية تانية إنها متجوزة واحد فاينانسير واحد رايح يديها فلوس تاني ماشي يعني العلاقة كده مفيش مودة ورحمة تمام so most if you look at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the last years of his life he was married to several ones and he was busy with da'wah teaching the Sahaba defending Medina receiving delegations sending delegations he didn't have time but still as reported in the authentic hadith in Sahih Muslim in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was in the service of his family He was cleaning the house, patching his clothes, fixing his shoes, milking his goat, keeping the house clean in order. And the Prophet ﷺ, if you look at it, he was terribly busy. He didn't have no time, but still he was helping and he was taking care of the house. Some of the brothers here, and I'm not talking about you, you are good people. Some of the brothers, when they go home, they feel like they're going to a hotel, man, a hotel. They go for some services, to sleep and to eat and leave and check out, right? And some of the sisters, the way they deal with their husbands, they deal as if he's the financier. He's just the money man. He just, you know, then he leaves. Therefore, some sisters, the most frequently word that some sister use after they get married is give. She never uses the word take. And they have this joke back home in Egypt. Someone protested to his wife and he said, we have been married for 7 years and you always use the word give and you never use the word take. So she said, fine, the fridge is broken, take it, fix it. Simple. لو نظرت إلى عمر الخطاب رضي الله عنه, we conclude with this, we can continue some other time when I relax a little bit. So, قالوا في الأدب الإسلامي يعني إنه مسألة الإحسان إلى الزوجة هو ألا تكف أذاك عنها ولكن تصبر على أذاه. ده معنى الإحسان. So they say in Arabic, being kind to your wife is not to harm her, but to be patient with her. This is the meaning of إحسان. يعني لو نظرت في قصة عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, وعمر رضي الله عنه في يعني حصل تغير في حياته. لو نظرت قبل الخلافة كان شديد. يعني إذا في قصة الأعرابي اللي تبول في المسجد وأراد أن هو يقتله وقال مش عارف إيه, وتجد في كذا حديث إنه كان عاوز يخلص عليهم على طول. وبعد لما تولى الخلافة وتحمل هموم الناس وأعبائهم وكذا ومسؤولياتهم, صار إنسانا مختلفا تماما, إنسانا رقيقا وكذا. So we conclude with this story from Umar رضي الله عنه. Before the Khilafah, before he became the Khalifa, he was very firm. I mean, you don't play games with him. In several hadith, when somebody said something or did something in the presence of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that Umar didn't like, of course, he wanted to rip off the head of the guy right away. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told him in several hadith, leave them alone, leave them alone. So after Umar radiallahu anhu became the Khalifa, subhanAllah, something happened. His heart was softened. And you see, for example, in the story, for example, there are several stories, but we'll focus on this one for now. جاء رجل إلى عمر رضي الله عنه ليشكو زوجته بترفع صوتها علي وعملاني مشاكل وجننان. فلما وصل الرجل إلى بيت باب عمر, سمع صوت زوجة عمر, صوتها جاي آخر الشارع. يعني هو كان بيقول إن أنا مراتي صوتها بيطلع بره الشقة الشقة, أما مراته عمر صوتها جاي آخر الشارع عند 132 بره كده, تمام. فلف وراجع مروح, مش نافع الموضوع, مصيبته أعظم من مصيبته. فرآه عمر رضي الله عنه فناداه, فقال له أنا جيت لك عشان أشتكي من زوجتي, ولكن أنت يبدو أن عندك مصائب أكثر مني, أنت مسكين. اللي يرى مشاكل الناس ومصائبهم تهون عليه مصيبته. فقال له لا يا أخي الكريم, يعني أمرنا بالصبر على النساء لأنه عندهم يعني أمور يمرون بها لا نمر بها, كالحمل وكالرضاعة وكالدورة وكذا, وعندهم مشاكل وأعباء وبيغسلوا وبيطبخوا وكذا, ونحن لا نفعل هذه الأشياء تمام في العادة, فلا بد أن نصبر على الأذى حتى نأخذ الثواب. So the man came to Umar to complain about his wife because she used to raise up her voice and the husband was not happy about this. When he went to Umar to complain to him, and Umar's wife was raising her voice to Umar, so if she is here and you know you were at North Gate, you can hear her voice from there, from a distance. So when the man saw this, he said, "La hawla la quwwata illa." I'm better off than Umar radiallahu anhu. He decided to leave. So Umar saw him and said, come here. Why are you here?" He said, "I came to complain about my wife, but it seems you have a more terrible problem than me." So Umar radiallahu anhu said, "We should be more patient with them. They go through things that we don't go through. Pregnancy, the monthly period, taking care of the kids, doing the dishes, changing the diaper, cooking and doing all that stuff. We don't do these things. So they're always stressed out. So we need to be more patient with them, and we will continue in the next time, inshallah. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وما ينفعنا ما علمنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وجزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.